As we have witnessed the first full-stacked Starship, we have also seen more and more pictures of what will eventually become the Starship's thermal protection system. This is crucial for the ultimate goal of rapid reusability, but the Space Shuttle had the same goals, we all know how that went. Reusability turned into full refurbishment, and quick turnaround became 5 months, 750,000 work hours and manual checkup of over 24,000 tiles. So what are the differences and improvements that SpaceX has in their sleeves, to make the dream of full and rapid reusability into reality? This is what I want to talk about, but first, to comprehend the insane level of the challenge, we need to understand some basic physics. So let's dive straight into it. Without burning up, any spacecraft in orbit has a lot of kinetic energy because of how fast it is going. Anyway, such a huge amount of energy needs to be somehow removed, and the only realistic way how to do this without burning additional fuel is to hit the atmosphere and convert the kinetic energy into heat. The problem is that 3 terajoules is so much energy, that if it was just instantly converted to heat within the Starship, it would raise its temperature by 64,000 degrees Celsius. And stainless steel melts at 1450 degrees Celsius, but fortunately, there are better ways of dissipating the heat. Once we realize what is actually happening when a re-entering spacecraft interacts with the atmosphere. The spacecraft moves so fast that the air in front of it cannot get out of the way quickly enough, and it gets compressed. We got a really good look at a near-complete thermal protection system. So the thermal protection system on Starship is absolutely critical to Starship doing. What it plans, Starship wants to be a rapidly reusable system, and it needs a thermal protection system, which needs almost no maintenance. So SpaceX have already developed a working heat shield for their Dragon spacecraft, but, it is a different beast. Entirely the Dragon capsule, it returns from space, lands in the water and then goes off to a factory to be refurbished, and the heat shield replaced. Because they're replacing the heat shield, they use an ablative heat shield. They use something called Pica X, phenolic impregnated carbon ablator, and the ablator part, what it is there's the resin, the phenolic resin that makes up this heat shield. When it gets hot due to the re-entry heating, it breaks down and creates gas, and that gas comes out through the surface and it provides a protective layer, and because of this, they can get away with a much thinner and lighter heat shield. Now Starship on the other hand is supposed to be rapidly reusable, that is the dream. That this thing can land it, can have a quick inspection and be put back on top of the launch vehicle, and head straight back to space, and that means, you can't afford to replace the entire heat shield every time. So you need to use an insulating type heat shield, that can handle the very high temperatures without breaking down, and the closest thing we've seen to that is the Space Shuttle, and the Space Shuttle had a pretty bad reputation, for its heat shield. Like it was eternally a problem, and indeed they lost one vehicle, because the heat shield was damaged, and they almost lost at least a couple of others. The heat shield needed a lot of inspection and replacement, between flights, so since the Space Shuttle had such problems. How do we think, that SpaceX can do the same thing with Starship but get rid of all the problems? Well, first of all, there's a few things that are on SpaceX's side. First of all, the Space Shuttle was mounted on site side, onto a tank, and the tank had flecks of foam, and ice, and those would fall off and impinge on the bottom surface. Which is where your heat shield is. Like, in retrospect, it would have made more sense to mount the Space Shuttle upside down on the tank. So the top of the shuttle would be getting damaged by this stuff, but you know, these are the kind of things you learn after you've flown for a while. SpaceX don't have this problem with Starship, because Starship sits on top. The other thing is the Space Shuttle had a very complex geometry. Meant that it needed lots of different tile designs to cover the entirety of the vehicle. If they had a tile that needed replaced, they had to go and get that exact tile from the thousands of different designs, and make sure it was inserted in there. There's other problems, that the Space Shuttle had that used aluminium, which had greater expansion than the stainless steel. That we'll be seeing on Starship, but, on the other thing is that Starship can afford to get warmer underneath or hotter, because, it's stainless steel. Whereas the shuttle had an aluminium structure underneath, so Starship's much simpler geometry means that the majority of the tiles, are these identical hexagonal designs. And you know, to get an idea of how big these things are, they're about the size of dinner plates. I think they're about 12 inches 30 centimeters across, and they are very easy to apply to the side of the structure. so you're not going in and applying strain isolation pads, and then glue and then spacers, and then supports and then the tile. You're literally going up and there's mounting pins, that have been pre-placed on there. There's a robot that goes in and welds on these mounting pins, with little spring clips in their head, and you basically just push the tile on and there are little holes in the tile. With metal brackets inside them and these will clip on, and one of the nice things is that, when it's mounted, there's actually some play in these holes and because, they use three of them, the tile can actually respond as the structure moves underneath it. So it's not like the Space Shuttle, where they had to have these fabric isolation pads, to stop the flexing from popping the tile off. It's really it has a lot of freedom to move. There is actually a pad underneath which we believe is some kind of ceramic wool design, it's probably made of silica or alumina fibers. It'll probably handle your temperatures of 1000 degrees Celsius quite easily, but it's not like a primary heat shield. By any means, if you lose a tile, I wouldn't rely on this to give you a significant amount of protection. So, anyway, a lot of the tiles just pop on like that. The biggest thing is that, you have to make sure that they're closed as close together, so that you minimize the amount of heat coming through these gaps. But not so close that, when the vehicle is in motion that they start banging together and potentially breaking. So there are areas where they need to have slightly irregular patterns. First of all, the Starship nose cone, that is a complex structure, because it curves and tapers towards a point. So they have a bunch of different strategies, for slowly shrinking these rings as they go up. The wings or the fins, those have a whole bunch of very specific shapes on them, and they're being filled in right now. Now only half of Starship is being tiled. The back end is only going to get plasma from the air trail, it's going to get like reflected heat from the radiate the thermal radiation. So the stainless steel is actually quite good at reflecting, that and that's what we'll use now on the Space Shuttle. You'll notice that the bottom off is black, because they wanted it to radiate heat efficiently. The top of it is white, because most of the heat was coming in by thermal radiation and so they wanted it, to reflect as much of that as possible. That's why the bottom of the shuttle is black and the same is true. On Starship the bottom is going to be black, because it's going to be you re-emitting as much thermal radiation as possible, and the top is going to be reflecting. The hexagon is a great shape because it offers, no straight path for hot gas to accelerate through the gaps, Musk added. If tests show any heat shield erosion for Starship, SpaceX plans to add additional cooling systems to protect the spacecraft. Transpiration cooling will be added wherever we see erosion of the shield, Musk wrote. Starship needs to be ready to fly again immediately after landing. Zero refurbishment. While the hex tiles will protect the Starship vehicle during re-entry, don't expect the polygonal heat shield on the Super Heavy booster, Musk said. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.